All right. Hey, hey, what's going on? It is, I actually clicked over to 9:46 as I was diligently working through my morning. And thank you for being here. You know, I really appreciate you for, you know, stopping your day for a few moments and spending some time together here with us. And this is really cool. I just want to acknowledge you for being here. You know, Monday mornings for a lot of people are very difficult to get up, get moving, get rocking and rolling. And, you know, we tend to punish ourselves for what we did or did not do over the weekend. Not you, though. You know, you're here because you're looking to make strides and move forward in what you're doing. So I wanted to talk a little bit here about, you know, what does it really take to be successful? What does it take to basically take your day and move it to a level where most people don't exist, don't know exists? And when you really look at the successful and take a look at what they have, it's easy to fall into what we see as entitlement and, you know, seeing what's not really there, creating our own story, falling into that story and creating, you know, excuses that we rationalize that we're not a certain type of a person or we don't know how to, you know, you can fill in the blank there. Oh man, I love it. I love hearing, just because of humor, I love hearing people say, well, I'm just not that kind of a person. Or, well, that's just the way I grew up. Or, that's just the way I am. So I don't believe any of that. I don't believe that you are predestined to be a certain type of person. I don't believe that we were designed to be anything but great, unless you want to be predestined to greatness. And that's obviously a different story there. You know, as we move through our lives and we start creating different things, we move into an area of, oh man, where we start creating excuses for ourselves as to why we're not going full out and why we're not creating the life that we know that we deserve. You see, I believe that you were designed to be great. I've always believed that. I can't say that. I believe that as far back as I can remember. I have literally brainwashed myself to the point where I don't believe in any other thing. And I look back as far back as I can remember, and I just have erased that limiting belief of possibility. And when you take a look at, you know, the uber successful, whether it's, you know, whether it's finances, whether it's relationships, whether it's money, or whether it's business, or whether it's personal, whatever it is, fitness, life, it doesn't really matter. When you take a real close look at what people do to become successful, it's actually quite a neat formula. And it's what most people don't do. And I almost missed it this morning. The boys and I woke up. I was in their room at 5:20 this morning. We were in the gym, 5:25, they got up, got dressed, got sneakers on, and boom, they were ready to go. They were both exhausted. I love my son. It came out anyways, though, because they have goals. You know, my oldest son made a bicep the other day. I think he's on his fifth week. I'm going to have to start documenting what week we're on. I'm going to have to write down a little note here for myself. I believe he's on week 5 right now, and my youngest is on week 3. So 5 and 3. So I can celebrate with them later tonight. 5 and 3. And I can see the transformation, not necessarily just physical, because my oldest made a bicep. He's like, Dad, look, he had a bicep. And my youngest, I watched him go from, you know, he's 8 years old. He's just a skinny little bean kid, man. He's so little. He takes after his mommy. And, you know, he was pressing 5 pounds at the beginning of last week, and at the end of last week and coming into this week, he went from 5 to 10s. He doubled his weight. So I was so excited. We celebrated so much. And so the very first thing is we need to really start celebrating who we are, what we've accomplished. You know, sometimes it doesn't seem like, you know, there's much to celebrate. So the very first thing, if you want to write things down, in fact, I know a lot of y'all that do Facebook Live, this is a great Facebook Live. You know, the very first thing is to celebrate. And it doesn't matter how little they are, how little the celebration is. You know, so I celebrated them both. I'm going to celebrate them again tonight, except for tonight is going to be a lot more intentional celebrations. I'm going to intentionally celebrate them at dinner with Danielle, or after dinner, maybe. I don't know, I have a call tonight during dinner. So I will, you know, maybe during prayer time while we go into bed, I'll celebrate them You know, Danielle and I will celebrate the boys for being consistent. You know, so the first thing is celebration, man. So you got to celebrate everything because it releases a certain chemical in our mind that we actually start craving. It kind of gets like a drug, like crack, which is if you're going to be addicted to something, be addicted to celebrating yourself. The next one is to when you, so in order to create consistency, it's not necessarily, you know, it's like, well, I have a daily plan. I'm just not consistent with it. Yeah, I totally get that. What we do is we need to create a sense of, what's the word I'm looking for? It's like pre-planning. I don't know. I can't remember the word. It doesn't really matter. Don't put meaning on it and just come with me. So don't look for the word. Just stay with me here. So the night before, set your intention out the night before. It's really, really important to set your intention out of what you're going to do, because if you do it first thing in the morning, you're like, oh, what am I going to do today? You're going to lose half hour, 45 minutes, sometimes an hour. I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time here. Just set your intentions out the night before. So when you wake up, your intentions have been set. See, we choose the night before. We don't choose the day of to get up. We chose it the night before. So all you're doing is remaining in integrity with yourself by staying with your choice. Right? You made a word. You created word with yourself. So So number two is set your intentions up the night before. I highly recommend. So number three is going to be meditation, vision. Meditating on your vision could be prayer. We do two chairs. We did two chairs again this morning. We do it many times as we possibly can throughout the week. You know, so the next one is meditation. You got to spend 5 to 10 minutes every single morning quieting your mind. And I don't care where it is. You've got to slow yourself down for a few minutes and just sit there. You know, I tell the boys, I'm like, look, it's not about the question that you're asking or even the answers that you're receiving. It's about sitting there and being still. And just, and the very first thing I said, all right, guys, the timer has been set. Take a deep breath. And they go, and I go, now exhale. I'm like, now go ahead and spend your time here. And we slow ourselves down. The next thing is this, is do one thing per day to increase self. Now, that could be your teacher, it could be your prayer, it could be your meditation. However, it's also very, very important to increase your education. Whatever the education is, it doesn't matter to me. It's what matters to you. So you want to take a moment and increase yourself. See, as you continue to grow, the successful, they don't ever slow down. And I'm not talking about as far as filling a schedule. I'm talking about they don't slow down as far as education. They don't. See, in my opinion, that if we're not moving forward, we're moving backwards. I don't believe we ever stay still. We don't stay plateaued. We're either backwards or forwards, and I don't believe there's a difference. I don't believe there's something in between. So as you're going through this and you're increasing yourself, you have no other option but to get better. And then the other one is exercise. And I don't know, as far as exercising goes, if you worked out 5 days a week for 5 minutes a day, that's an amazing start. That's perfect. Congratulations. It comes down to being consistent. And once you're consistent with your exercises, you start feeling differently. You know, I can accomplish this. You know, maybe next week I'm going to make 5 10-minute exercises. Now you're exercising for almost an hour a week, which isn't too shabby. You've burned probably around 400 calories. That's awesome. For most people, that's an entire meal. Congratulations on that. And why do we exercise? Well, exercise increases these certain endorphins in our mind that makes us feel better. It also, our skin starts changing, because we're getting great circulation, right? The next one here is after the exercise is drink plenty of water. And it sounds like a lot of things, but it should be things that we're doing anyways. You know, drinking plenty of water isn't drinking a couple of 8 ounce glasses a day. And I really wish, I'm gonna have to look it up. You know, whatever these giant, oh, here we go, 30 ounces. So perfect. So I drink 3 of these a day. That's about 90 ounces of water. That's me. You know, you should be drinking at least 50% of your body weight in water each and every single day, because when you don't, you're not functioning correctly. Your brain isn't functioning. You're not getting enough oxygen to your brain, so you're not able to think correctly. You know, one of the quickest things that will slow down our thinking is being dehydrated. And a lot of us, we don't think of being dehydrated if we're not exercising on a daily basis. Well, when you're sleeping, you're perspiring. We don't even know it. Most of us don't. I mean, some of us do. Goodness gracious, sometimes I wake up in my own swimming pool. However, you want to make sure you're drinking plenty of water. Now, the last one here is this is create your day. Now, I know a lot of people say, well, you know, I woke up in a state of chaos because I woke up and my phone was going off, you know, all these things are going off at work. People are asking me to do things and all these different things. And, you know, how can I possibly create my day? A lot of times creating your day doesn't have anything to do with the actual activities in it. It has everything to do with your mindset going into the day. I know that today I had a huge list of things that I need to get finished before a 6 o'clock call that I'm doing tonight. And if you looked at it, it looked incredibly chaotic, except for this. I took that day and I created the mindset around it. The mindset is, I will finish everything that's possible to get finished. Because the moment that we state, I don't know if I'm going to get this finished, we actually gave up control in our day. We just gave it up. We gave it up to chance. Now, when you list things out, like I listed my things out, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then and that's 4 things that I thought about on the way home. There was about a half a dozen things that I thought about this morning. As we're doing our 2 chairs, God speaks all kinds of neat things into me. So when we start looking at this stuff, now if I had 10 things to do, if I have an 8-hour period, that is less than an hour each. So what I need to do, what's necessary is, all right, so out of all the things on this list, if I don't get what, if something doesn't get finished, what would be the least crucial? The least that I need to do. And I looked on this list right here, there's 2 things I can knock off immediately that if they don't get done today, I can do them tomorrow. Because here's the thing. I could stay up until midnight, finish off my list. However, what's that going to do for me tomorrow? If I get 4 hours instead of 6 hours sleep, how productive am I going to be tomorrow? Probably not very. So maybe I only have 6 things tomorrow. However, my mind is not there because I'm exhausted. So then I'm only maybe operating at 60 or 70% of my potential. Instead of doing what I can today, paying very close attention to my rest so I can be optimal. And then I can maybe, just maybe, I can knock out everything off my list tomorrow because I'm operating on all 8 cylinders, if you're an 8-cylinder car. And you can get things finished. See, this is called living at a level of consciousness, instead of letting your subconscious mind rule your day. See, when we let our subconscious rule our day, it's basically being predicated on the past. Just kind of wrap your head around that for a minute here. If we're allowing our subconscious mind to rule the day, basically creating subconscious choices all day long, it's going to be almost impossible to move forward at the rate that you want to move forward because it's all predicated on what's possible from the past. When you create your day according to what you want to do, it changes the game a little bit here. When you're creating your day, you're moving forward because you're moving into a realm of possibility that hasn't existed yet. And this is a topic here that I'm going to go into in more detail as we continue moving forward here. On creating possibility that has never existed, that will literally melt your brain off. I went through some education over the weekend and I came running out. And in fact, I was texting Danielle. I was messaging her. I was doing all these things, getting her attention, saying, we need to have more conversations about this. Because it just lit me up. And I'm gonna tell you what, when you see someone on fire, you look at that and then you take gasoline and throw them on them. That's me right now. So these things right here that we're talking about right here, this is what the success will do. This is what we've implemented in my life. Danielle is she's one of my accountability partners, love her to pieces, holds no punches, and that's why I like it. And, you know, that's the way we should be in our own lives. So here's the thing. Follow these. Move in this direction. Create something amazing for yourself. You deserve it. You were born great. There's nothing in the way to stop you from being the greatest person that ever lived. Nothing, absolutely nothing. We are born great. The day we came on this earth, we were the greatest person ever. as far as us concerned. And we were amazing. And here's the thing. The only thing that changed was somebody said something or things, circumstances, and situations happened. Now, if you take a look at that time in the past, our very first moments on earth, our greatest moments on earth, and the things that happened in the person now, the only thing that's in the way is the stuff that we give meaning to. Take that meaning off for a few minutes and ask yourself this question. If I didn't have meaning or emotions in this situation right now, what would I do and what would I be able to accomplish? And the moment that you do that, things become clear. And when they're clear, that's when you can see an open realm of possibility. So I appreciate you. Thank you for hanging out with me. I will be uploading this to YouTube. It'll be on, in fact, if you need to Google it on, or Google it on YouTube, I guess it's probably kind of the same since they're both the same now. But if you search it on YouTube, you can look up Monday Morning Mindset. And that's where I'm going to have all these recordings. I love you. Have an absolutely outstanding day. I will speak to you soon. And here's to you being the greatest person to ever live.